Just like your right hand and left hand both have five fingers but look different, coordinate systems also have an orientation to them. When you define a set of axes, you also need to specify one other fact, whether the axes are in right-handed or in left-handed system. Here's an example of a right-handed coordinate system. Say I want to build a building. I define the x-axis as going east and the y-axis as going north. Now my floor plan shows x pointing right, y pointing up. This is the standard 2D Cartesian coordinate system. If I define altitude as the z-axis, with the arrow coming out of the diagram towards the viewer, this is a right-handed coordinate system. Why is this right-handed? Well, if you place your thumb along the x-axis and the index finger along the y-axis, the middle finger is the z-axis and points towards you. You'll notice if you try to do the same thing with your left hand, you can't match up all three axes, at least not comfortably. This is a left-handed coordinate system. The key thing to realize is that the left-handed coordinate system is equally valid. It does not change the underlying reality of the situation. For example, intelligent rabbits might agree that x is east and y is north, that's fine. However, they might decide that the z-axis points down into the page. The rabbits care more about how far down a tunnel is dug from ground level and want to say 5 feet instead of -5 feet when they're digging. This is a left-handed coordinate system. The underlying reality is the same in both cases. Nothing has changed place. Just how we and the rabbits refer to location differs. When we say 12 meters, the rabbits would say -12 meters and vice versa. To convert between these particular two systems is simply a matter of negating the z-coordinate value.